All right, to perform the hip hinge, we're gonna start with the feet hip width apart, and we're gonna place one hand at the waistline and one hand at the top of the rib cage. Now, instead of curling the back like so, causing pain and discomfort, we're going to instead keep the back in a locked position, and we're gonna send the hips backwards to bring the upper torso closer towards the floor. What we don't wanna do is we don't want to curl the back, bring the hands closer together, because that's gonna cause more instability at the low back, which will in turn cause pain. And we don't want to arch the low back like so, bringing the hands further apart from one another, because this will cause excess pressure on the spine and in turn also cause pain. So we're just maintaining that width between the hands at the same distance as we're coming down into that hip hinge.